Hey friends, welcome to this video on electrical switches at Gyan Lab. So I have kept a very interesting study for you which will really help you understand how do switches work. And so for this activity I have as usual my light source, that's a bulb, a battery holder with two batteries, a couple of connecting wires, one actual switch and a L-shaped bracket and a copper plate which I will use to create my own switch and help you understand that how does a switch actually function. So for this activity what we will first do is we'll try and build the circuit with the help of regular switch, and then we shall move on to the switch with L-shaped bracket and the copper wire. So let's get started. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to first connect the two connecting wires to the bulb holder. So the connection with the bulb has been made. Now I'll go ahead and loosen the two screws at the switch that we can see. And what I'll do is I'll connect the negative end of the battery holder, which is this green wire, and one of the ends of the bulb to the lower screw that you can see at the switch, and the positive end of the bulb holder along with the second connecting wire will go at the higher screw of the switch. So let's quickly do this. So as you can see, I have connected the battery holder and the bulb to the switch as we had earlier stated, and I am now going to turn the bulb, the switch over. And now the switch is in the off position, as you would normally know. So I'm going to quickly fix the two batteries here. Sorry, this was the off position. So when I actually switch it on, the bulb glows. So now I'll explain this phenomena with the help of the L-shaped bracket and the copper strip that we have here. Okay, so what I am now left with is I've kept the two connecting wires already connected to the bulb holder, and so what we're going to do is we're going to build a simple series circuit where we're going to connect the negative end of the battery holder to one of the connecting wires, the positive end of the battery holder to the L-shaped bracket, and the third end of the the second end of the bulb holder, and which is this connecting wire, to the copper plate. And then we are going to see how does the switch actually function. Right, so let's quickly get started. We are going to first connect the negative end of the battery holder to the bulb, which is done. I'm going to connect the positive end of the battery holder to the L-shaped bracket, and it's very simple. All you need to do is loop it in so that it stays intact in its position. And for the third connection that I need to make here, what I'll probably do is I'll use some tape so that this particular connection stays in place. So once I'm done with this, my switch is ready. So I'm going to just place in the batteries quickly, and when I connect this, you'll see the bulb glows. Right, so what is happening is the switch is in the off position right now, and the moment I connect these two together, switch is in, the switch is actually on and it starts working. So this same principle works in an electric switch. So what happens is when the switch is off position, the metallic part inside the switch is actually disconnected, and when I switch it on, because of the switch moving inwards, the two metallic parts come into contact, because of which the circuit starts conducting electricity, and that's how a switch works. So you now know as to how your household switches work, and I'm pretty sure you can explain the same phenomena to all your friends. So do try this activity at home and make sure that you have adult supervision while you're doing this. Thank you.